it's Emma and welcome back to my channel. First things first, I have not filmed a sit down video like this in the longest time. I was trying to think the last one that I did, pack with me video that I did before I left England, which would have been back in November. So obviously the main videos that I've been doing have been vlogs and I absolutely love vlogging. Vlogs are still my favourite videos to make, but I have kind of missed sitting down and just doing like a talking video. So that is what we are going to do today. And if you've got any requests of any videos that you would like to see, particularly that are not vlogs, like more sit down videos, let me know in the comments. But anyway, today I wanted to talk to you guys all about au pairing. So if you've not been following my channel or my Instagram, I am currently an au pair in Brisbane, Australia. I've lived here in Brisbane and in Australia for 3.5 months now. And I thought today I would just tell you everything that you need to know about being an au pair. Obviously, I have mentioned in some of my vlogs so far that I'm an au pair here. And then on my Instagram, I talk a lot about au pairing on there. Do you get a ton of questions on my Instagram, on my YouTube about au pairing and what it involves? So I thought it'd be useful to just have one video where I literally tell you everything. So I have made some notes in my journal and I've tried to cover pretty much every topic, but if you do have any extra questions, if there's anything that I don't mention or anything that you want me to clarify, please feel free to comment them below. So first things first, before anything else, what is an au pair? This is probably my number one question whenever I tell people that I'm an au pair. I always describe an au pair as more like a babysitter, or even better, more like a big sister, because you're actually living with the family and you're supposed to be like integrated into the family, treated like a member of the family. So it's not like you are a nanny in the sense that you are like an outsider coming in. You're an employee, you're employed by the family. That's the main point that I try and get across about being an au pair, is that you are more like a sister to the kids. So yeah, as an au pair, you are welcomed by a host family and it's sort of described as a cultural exchange in that sense. So rather than it being a job, even though you do get some money from it, it is not officially looked at as a job or as employment. So I will get into a little bit more detail about what I do as an au pair. But the schedule and the things that you do might vary family to family. So there's not like a one rule for all. Also, another point about au pairing in non-English speaking countries. When I did it in France and Spain and in any other non-native English speaking countries, the main focus and the main kind of purpose of bringing an au pair is all to do with English. So it's to do with the kids being exposed to English, being with a native speaker, improving their English, whereas obviously in Australia it's a bit different because they don't need that. Here, au pairing is more about just being a helping hand for busier parents, helping to support the kids and like be there for them and help them with their busy schedules and stuff like that. So just to really quickly tell you what I do as an au pair, I do talk about this a lot on my Instagram. So again, if you want to follow me there, you can see more au pairing content and on my TikTok as well. But basically the main thing that I do is I drive the kids to and from school. And I also make their breakfast in the morning. I make their packed lunches for school. A few other responsibilities, like making sure that they're wearing their uniform and that it's clean. I don't do the laundry, but just like making sure that they look right for school. Making sure they've packed their homework and they've got everything that they need. Just little reminders like that. Taking them to and from their after school clubs. So the kids that I'm currently au pairing for have a lot of after school activities. They've got something on every single day. So honestly, the main thing that I do is driving them to and from their after school clubs. So like soccer, drama, whatever's going on. Then I usually also make their dinners as well, so I'll do that before I take them to the after school clubs or maybe afterwards. And I finish up in the evenings, Monday to Thursday, about 7 p.m, like whenever the parents get home really. And then on Fridays I'm free all day after the school drop off, and I'm off on Saturdays and Sundays. Monday to Thursday, obviously during the day while they're at school, so between like 8:10 and 3 o'clock I'm free. So a lot of free time, which is one of the benefits that I'm going to get into. So now I'm going to talk to you guys about the benefits of being an au pair. Why would you want to be an au pair? What do you get as an au pair? Let me tell you, there are a lot of health benefits. It is really, really something that you should consider doing if you're someone who wants to travel a bit more, but you are on a budget, you don't have a lot of money saved, you want to be able to save money while traveling, while working abroad. So there's kind of three main benefits that every au pair should get, and then any additional benefits on top of that just depend on what individual host family and what things they are offering. Three main things that you should get as an au pair are free accommodation, so you are living with your host family. The living arrangements again depend from family to family. Obviously some arrangements are better than others. Sometimes a family might have a separate apartment that you live in, or a separate part of the house that has its own entrance, and it's basically like your own flat. The second big benefit is all of your food and board, so you don't pay for any food, you have all your meals included. And the third benefit is a weekly allowance. So this is called an allowance or pocket money rather than a salary, because as I explained, it is not really a job and you're not employed. It's more of an exchange, a cultural exchange. You do receive all of these benefits and this kind of package. Again, the weekly allowance should vary family to family, but certain countries do have laws in place which state like a minimum amount that au pairs should get paid. Just to give you guys an idea, when I was in Europe, this was quite a few years ago, I first was an au pair in Madrid in Spain, and I got paid €70 a week as my allowance, but bearing in mind that I did not have any expenses, so my €70 was just for me to spend at the weekends or whenever I wanted. When I was an au pair in Paris a couple of years later, I got €100 a week, again with no expenses. And currently in Australia I get $375 a week. I would say generally, from what I've seen and from my experiences, that the benefits in Australia, from all the families that I've seen advertised as well, not just this one, the benefits in Australia seem to be better than what you get in Europe. So those are the main benefits, and obviously that alone is enough to cut off a ton of money that you would be spending if you were traveling or living abroad without au pairing. And then, as I said, you'll probably get some extras as well, which are dependent on the family. So when I was living in Madrid, I got a monthly transport card, which I could use on the metro and stuff to get around Madrid. I thought that was inside, but it was just on the window. Here in Australia, I have my car and all my petrol paid for as well. Another benefit is money to spend when I go out with the kids. So if I want to take them for ice cream, if I want to take them bowling, whatever, I have money from the family to pay for us to do that, me as well. And then also going on any family trips or outings. So sometimes you may be invited on trips or holidays with the family. You might go out for dinners, so we probably go out for dinner as a family like once a week or once a fortnight or something. So, and if we go out as a family, then they pay for the meal, including my meal as well. So those are pretty much the benefits of au pairing. And now I'm just going to go into like the pros and cons of au pairing. There are pros and there are cons, and it's a lot to think about before you sign up to do this, so I want to tell you like both sides. So I'll start out with the pros, because there are definitely more pros than there are cons. So obviously the number one pro is that au pairing is allowing you to travel for free. You are living for free without any expenses. You don't need a lot of savings. Obviously you do need to pay for your flight and your visa if you need one. The second pro is that it's just a really good experience. It allows you to gain experience in a lot of different fields. So if you're not sure what career you want to do, or if you are sure that you want a specific career like childcare or teaching, then au pairing gives you experience in a lot of those fields. Also gives you the experience of learning another language and another culture if you do it in a non-English speaking country. So I've got a degree in French and Spanish, and I did my au pairing in France and Spain during my university summers, so it was a good chance for me to practice my French and Spanish, to learn about the culture. Likewise, I know a lot of people do au pairing in Australia because they want to improve their English, they want to learn English and live with like native English speakers. Another big pro is the fact that you will feel like you have a home, and you will have a home away from home. if you're moving abroad solo and maybe you're a little bit scared about not having a home, you don't want to be living in hostels, you're not sure about finding a place to live when you arrive. If you want something where it is all set up before you get to the country, you've got a home to go to, you've got a job in the sense that you've got money coming in and you've got no expenses when you first arrive, then au pairing is a perfect solution for you because you don't have any of that stress when you first move here. I think this point also really applies to anyone who thinks that they might get homesick being so far from home, especially if you are coming to Australia. Obviously, it's the other side of the world, it's very far away. If you have not travelled a lot or if you've not lived abroad before, au pairing is great because you do have that family around you and you do feel like you sort of are settled in a place and like you're not alone. Or you should do if you've got a good host family, that is. We'll get onto that in a minute. Another big pro is saving money. If you're someone who wants to save up a lot of money, then au pairing is a good solution for you. Not so much if you are doing it in Europe without a working visa, but if you are coming to Australia, you can save a hell of a lot of money being an au pair because wages in Australia are incredibly high, and obviously you're living for free, so anything you earn from your au pairing, anything you earn from additional jobs that you take on, like I've got a job in a cafe, all of that money you can in theory save if you want to because you've not got any outgoing expenses. Okay, so now I'm going to go into talking about the cons, because don't be fooled, while au pairing is amazing, there are obviously cons, there are downsides. Like anything in life, there's good and bad. So I'm going to tell you the bad just so that you are aware of it, or not necessarily the bad, but you know, things to think about if you want to do this. So the first one, obviously, you are going to be living with other people that you don't know initially. You do come to know them because you're living together, and if you've got a good host family who looks after you and appreciates you and makes you feel welcomed, then it won't feel like you are living with strangers. Obviously, it's something to think about if you are someone who has previously lived by yourself or who doesn't really like living with other people. Number two, this is also quite a big one, is the kids' behaviour. You are working with kids, you are surrounded by kids, and at times, you know, children can be difficult, they can be challenging. The thing with au pairing is that as an au pair, you are not a qualified nanny. You don't have childcare experience in most cases unless you are doing this as someone who does, which is great, but most of us don't. Yeah, if you don't have a lot of experience with kids, I mean, even if you do, you might just not have experience with certain scenarios until it happens. I think with au pairing, like, you learn as you go. It's a learning experience. I would say it's definitely worth it, and don't be put off by being afraid of how the kids might behave or how they may act, because most of the time, kids are great. Working with kids can be really, really rewarding. But I'm telling you guys this because I know there are some people who just outright don't like kids. Not in a mean way, but they just don't. They, like, some of my friends have said to me, they could never be an au pair. They don't know how I do it. They don't like hanging out with kids. Like, you know, some people, it's just not for them. Which is why I want to tell you that you have to obviously be aware of that, because the kids are the biggest part of the equation. So if you are someone who really thinks that you will not work well with kids and it's not something that you can see yourself doing, then obviously au pairing is probably not for you. So another con may be the schedule and the work that is required of you. I think this could only be a con if it's not something that you have confirmed before you arrive. So I always say to people who want to be an au pair, when you are speaking with families and like interviewing with them, make sure that it is really clear to you what your schedule is, what the hours are, exactly what's required of you. And if you take the position, then make sure that you have a contract where it is all written out clearly. Another con, I do hear some people say that they think that the pay is not enough. But what's important to remember is that in this kind of package, you don't get a full wage or a full salary. You get a weekly allowance, but then you do also get all of the other benefits. And I think if you add up how much you would pay on rent, how much you'd pay on food, car, petrol, any other extras that you get, you are getting a lot more than what you would get in a salary. And then I think the final con that I wrote down was maybe feeling like you have less freedom because you are living with a family. I suppose it's sort of like if you've been to uni and you've lived at uni, or you've lived by yourself, you've been travelling, and then you go back to living at your parents' house. It can kind of feel like that because you're living with a family. A lot of host families, you know, they might have rules that they want you to follow, like, I don't know, not bringing back people to stay overnight, which maybe that's something that you would do or could do if you had your own house. So now I'm going to tell you guys about how to get a job as an au pair if this is something that you want to do. So the first approach you can take is using an agency. I recommend an agency called Au Pair World, which is a free website. I use this for France and Spain. So basically you make a profile about yourself and then you can find families, look at their profile. There are a lot of other au pair agencies. I would say be wary of any agencies that are asking you to pay money to be a member or to help you find a family. I personally don't think that you need to be paying anyone to find a family. The second approach you can take to finding an au pair job, this is how I found mine for Australia, and it is a really popular way to find au pair placements in Australia, and that is Facebook. So there are a bunch of Facebook groups about au pairing. I'll insert a screenshot of two of the main Facebook groups that I use and that I recommend. This is where I found my current au pair job. And all you have to do basically is join these Facebook groups, you put in a post about yourself, and then families will also post in the group their own descriptions of themselves and their family, what they are looking for from an au pair, where they're based, what they're offering. Yeah, that's how you find them. You just comment on their posts if it's one that you're interested in, send them a message, and then from there you can arrange to do video calls, to speak with them further. So I'm now going to tell you guys a few tips for while you are looking for a family. I know this video is getting quite long, so I'm going to wrap it up soon. Number one is make sure that you are speaking to a lot of families. So do a lot of different video calls, reach out to a lot of different people. Make sure you have your options open and that you've fully explored all of them. Also, while you're speaking to families, make sure that you're doing video calls. Obviously, you don't want to be just doing it all on Facebook Messenger. You want to be able to actually see them, how they interact with you, what their body language is. I feel like you can get a really good vibe of what someone is like from a video call, definitely more than you can from messaging. Also, for the video calls, make sure that you've got any questions prepared, and I recommend having a lot of questions to ask because it makes you look like you are more interested, and it's also good for you because then you can find out as much as you can about this family that you're going to be potentially living with. So important things to ask are about the kids, what are they like, what things do they like doing. That makes you seem like you're really interested in the kids and not just in the benefits. Also, while looking for a host family and speaking to families, think about your own requirements. So, is there anything specific? Like, do you want to be in a certain city? Have you got requirements about the kids being certain ages? Like, you don't want to work with younger children? Something that I would stress to you guys is that the family are the most important aspect, and I would definitely choose this over a location or over any material things. So let's say you're speaking to an amazing family who sound like they're going to treat you so well, but then another family has a certain benefit, like, I don't know, a bigger house or a nicer car, or they're offering you a bit more money. I would always go for the family who you feel like you've got more of a connection with, because the family is everything. Like, getting the right host family can make or break your experience as an au pair, so I would always prioritise the relationship that you feel like you have with a family. And then finally, I'm just going to give you a few quick tips on being an au pair, but I can do a whole video on this if you would like me to. So first of all, take the good days with the bad. Au pairing sometimes can be difficult. Like I said, some days maybe the kids' behaviour isn't great, maybe you're homesick, maybe you're not sure about the family that you live with. I don't know, there can be good days and there can be bad days. Definitely in the beginning, as you're getting adjusted to the whole experience, but I recommend that you stick it out, give it a try. Don't give up at the beginning because you feel homesick or because you're not sure if you like it. Be as open-minded as possible. Obviously, you might be experiencing a new culture, new parenting methods, things that you've not experienced before. So you have to be open-minded. You are in someone else's country. this is someone else's culture. Be open-minded and be willing to learn about how they do things. Don't go in there with the approach that everything that you know is what's right, if that makes sense. You have to be open to learning new things. Be creative. This is really important as an au pair. Kids really enjoy when you are creative with them in terms of the activities that you do with them. Try your hardest to create a bond with the family, and that includes the parents as well as the children. Yes, as an au pair, you have a lot of free time and you can do what you want in your free time. So if the parents get home and you want to go to your room and sit in your room, you can do because it's your free time. But I would advise you guys to make the effort to have dinners with the family sometimes, at least sometimes. You know, talk to the family, tell them about your life, tell them what you're doing during the day, tell them about your friends, like open up to them, and you're going to have a better relationship and it's going to be an all-round better experience for everyone than if you completely close yourself off to them and just don't interact with them. That makes it a little bit weird for everyone because you're living together, they're welcoming you into their home, they're giving you all this stuff, and try different approaches with the kids. So if you find that the kids are misbehaving, if they're not listening to you, if they're not doing what they should be doing, just try a different approach. Like I said, most au pairs are not trained in childcare. We don't have that professional experience. You've just got to learn on the job. So if you find that they're not responding to you in a certain way, try a different method. Like try asking them a different way. Obviously every child has different behaviour as well. So what you previously know from kids that you've looked after before may not work with the kids that you're looking after now. So just look up different approaches if you're not sure. You can look it up online, speak to other au pairs, speak to the parents. And then my final tip for being an au pair is to make the most of it. Like I said, it is such a unique opportunity to live for free, to have someone else paying for everything, to be able to experience another country and not have to pay for it. Like, it is a crazy, crazy good setup and experience. Yeah, just make the most of it, save money, travel the country in your free time, enjoy it. Yes, there's going to be good and bad days, but like make the most of it because it is a dream scenario really to have someone else paying for your whole life. It's that doesn't happen, so enjoy it. Okay, so that is everything that I wanted to tell you guys today about au pairing. As I said, if there's anything that I have not covered or if you've still got any questions, please do comment them below and I'd be really happy to help. If you want to see more au pairing content on my channel, then let me know. Also follow my TikTok and my Instagram because I'm posting a lot of au pair content on there as well. Make sure you subscribe to see more of my life in Australia, and I will see you guys in a video soon. Thank you for watching. Bye.